In this example, we're asked to solve the quadratic equation 49x squared minus 36 equals 0 using the quadratic formula. Hopefully we recognize that we could solve this by factoring since this is a difference of squares, but we'll go ahead and solve this using the quadratic formula and then check it by factoring. So the first thing we should recognize is that the equation is in the correct form, where the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. Therefore, a is equal to positive 49, b would be 0, and c is equal to negative 36. So again, a is equal to 49, b is equal to 0 since there's no x term, and c is equal to negative 36. Now we'll perform substitution into the quadratic formula. So we'll have x equals negative b, that's going to be negative 0, plus or minus the square root of b squared, that's 0 squared, minus 4 times a, which is 49, times c, which is negative 36. All divided by 2 times a, or 2 times 49. So now we'll begin to simplify. We'll have x equals, this is just 0, so we have plus or minus the square root of, this would be negative 4 times 49 times 36, which is actually equal to 7,056, divided by 2 times 49, which is 98. Now it's difficult to recognize, but 7,056 is a perfect square. If we take the square root of 7,056, it comes out perfectly to 84, which means x is equal to plus or minus 84 divided by 98. And this fraction does simplify. 84 is equal to 6 times 14, and 98 is equal to 7 times 14. Well, of course, 14 over 14 simplifies to 1, so we have x equals plus or minus 6 sevenths, or if we want, we can say x equals positive 6 sevenths, or x equals negative 6 sevenths. And because we have two real rational solutions, this does tell us that the original equation was factorable. So to check our solutions, let's go ahead and solve this by factoring. 49x squared minus 36 is a difference of squares, so it'll factor into two binomial factors. 49x squared is equal to 7x times 7x. 36 is a perfect square since it's equal to 6 times 6. And one binomial will be a sum, one binomial will be a difference. So if this product is equal to 0, then 7x plus 6 must equal 0, or 7x minus 6 must equal 0. Here we would subtract 6 on both sides, divide by 7. Here's one solution of x equals negative 6 sevenths. And over here we would add 6 to both sides, divide by 7. We have our second solution of x equals 6 sevenths. So again, normally when given a choice, if we can factor the quadratic, we would solve it by factoring. But remember, the quadratic formula will solve any quadratic, whether the solutions are real, rational, irrational, or even complex. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.